I've shown this picture before. Carl was very optimistic, to say the least. I was very skeptical from the start, though. And now, Cosmic has missed both the beta window and the first release window. Now, will they release this year? I think that is very likely. Will they have a second one? Probably not. And I know I've made fun of this before, but if you're gonna make fun of it yourself, you basically give me the right to do so. Cosmic Alpha 7, never been beta. And for the sake of this video, I am recording on Cosmic, which is slightly problematic, as you can probably tell from what the cursor is doing. Right now, the portal is very, very broken. So if you want to do video capture, I would encourage you not to use Cosmic at the moment. But most of you aren't doing that, and everything else actually doing pretty good. Workspaces can now be moved by clicking and dragging. Reorder workspaces on the current display or move them across displays to your liking. Pinning a workspace will keep it from being removed when it's empty. This feature allows you to have a persistent or fixed number of workspaces open at a time. Simply hover your mouse over the workspace preview in the overview and click the pin. Together with workspace naming, pinned workspaces help to keep you organized as you navigate the desktop. Now, you may have noticed I didn't show you workspace naming. I cannot work out how to do a rename. There's no button here. There's no text entry field. If there is a way to do it currently, it is not at all clear. For those in need of accessibility features, four new accessibility features have been added to Cosmic. Firstly, a high contrast mode uses a high contrast theme affecting various elements for easier visibility, calculated automatically by Cosmic's theming system using a specialized method. What this translates to is there's very likely going to be some bugs, so if you are the kind of person who needs that, please do go and test it and let them know if there's anything that is particularly a problem for you. As you probably noticed from the video, it's not really a high contrast mode yet. It's more like we added borders to things. So for those who need that, please do give them feedback to improve that massively. Secondly, color filters for various forms of color blindness. I am not going to try to read these words, but you know what you are if you have some form of color blindness. If you don't, you should probably address that. Also, there is a grayscale filter as well. As for the lack of video with the color filters, turns out they actually won't show up in the video capture, so probably a good thing? I don't actually know. A few weeks back, I did make an issue about the lack of a slider. Right now, there is the filter on or off. There is no intensity slider, which I know for some people can be beneficial. We also have color inversion, which I never actually realized was an accessibility feature. But apparently for people with colorblindness, it can help you differentiate different colors. The more you know. Also, by incredibly popular demand, mono sound setting for those with hearing loss to combine left and right sound channels into a single channel for both ears. People constantly ask me how to do this. I don't know how to set it up. So the fact there's just a little toggle for it, really, really nice. And the magnifier has seen some improvements. Firstly, it can now be disabled. Before, it was always on. So if you didn't want it, sucks to be you. Now there is a toggle. Super plus scroll can also be disabled. So if you don't want the mouse zooming and you only want the keyboard zooming, that can be done as well. Fix the bug where Super Plus Scroll would crash Cosmic Compositor on some GPUs. Some would be mine included. If I zoomed in too quickly, consistently dies. And improve movement when view moves when pointer reaches edge is chosen. I don't really know what it was like initially, so I cannot comment on the improvements made there. Now, I didn't even notice this wasn't here, but hovering over an item in the app tray, in the workspaces, in the app library, in the launcher, should show a tooltip now indicating what the application is. Now, I have noticed that in some things, like the launcher, let's search for Florp, there doesn't appear to be a tooltip. I don't know if, like, it indicated there's supposed to be one here, but I'm not seeing anything. So I don't know what's being said there. It definitely works in the bar, though. One thing I've been waiting for a very long time, and I made a dedicated video on, is global shortcuts. Not the global shortcuts portal. That will be coming sometime soon. But the legacy X11 global shortcut support. Global shortcuts for applications allow you to use an application-specific shortcut even if that application is not in focus. And considering focus is very scuffed in Cosmic, where you have to click on a window or you have to immediately snap between them as you drag your mouse across, very useful in the case of things like OBS. This is off by default to protect privacy, but can be set to recognize modifier keys, or all keys only while modifiers are being pressed. A toggle for recognizing mouse events across applications is included here as well. So if there are any applications like Discord with push to talk or OBS with changing scenes, this can now be done if the application is run through X-Wayland. It won't work on the Wayland side just because of Waylandness, but running it through X-Wayland should get that done. And for people paying attention, this is not a unique idea. This was just yoinked from KDE because it's a great feature and it should be yoinked from KDE. Frankly, every single desktop should be doing this on Wayland. I know there's this push for the portal solution, but the portal is a future solution that applications are not using. There are users today who have needs, who want things to work. Whilst we're talking about X11, new settings for X-Wayland fractional scaling give Cosmic a better approach for handling fractional scaling with X11 applications. Optimized for applications allows apps that don't support applications to appear crisp and clear on screen. Meanwhile, optimized for full screen / gaming allows the application to match your screen resolution, though their scaling may look different alongside apps that support fractional scaling. These options can be found in display settings under X11 Windows System Application Scaling. That was on the same screen that I showed you before in the key section. So I don't know what that means. Look, here's what I'm going to tell you, right? Play with the settings, and the one that looks better, do that one. Don't read what it says. Just click the different things. And if one of them looks gooder, do the gooder one. That's pretty much a good way to do it, right? It doesn't matter what it says. If it looks better, just go with that one. I also don't use high DPI screens because I don't want to deal with problems like this. I will be 1080p until it is taken from my cold dead hands. Also, there's been some changes to the shortcut system. One of them is it works again. There was a brief period where you couldn't make shortcuts because they removed the text field on the shortcut entry, which was not great, but it's fixed now. Anyway, when moving focus outside of a stack with super arrows, the tab you started will remain shown as long as you continue to hold super. Workspaces now take priority over displays. Moving windows or window focus will navigate through workspaces on the same display first and then switch to the next display when present. Likewise, the initial display continues to show the workspace you started from until you release super. That needs some further explanation because that is confusing, and frankly, I do not like this being how it works. At least this being how it works as the only option. So right now I'm focused on my main monitor on workspace 1. If I focus to the left, that's going to go to my left-hand monitor to my OBS window. Makes sense. It didn't change workspaces, nothing like that. Focus right. Now it does something weird. Now I'm focused on workspace 2 on the left-hand monitor. If I focus right again, now I have focused back on my main monitor. If I focus right from here, now we're in workspace 2. Now we're in an empty workspace. Now we're in another empty workspace because these ones I have pinned. So if you want to focus a window to the right, it has to go through the blank workspaces. If I then do it again, now we're in workspace 5, that empty workspace at the end. Now, if I change focus, now I'm on my right-hand monitor. This is not good behavior. If you want to have that as an option, totally fair, right? Like that, fine, let people do that. But if I focus to the right and I have a window open on my right-hand monitor, I do not want to cycle through every single workspace. I want to focus on the window to my right. You can now cycle back to the first workspace in order from the last and vice versa. This will no longer move you to another display when not moving windows. So if we do control super right, and now we're back at the start. Same as in the other direction, that'll take us to the end. Great change. Like that. The shortcut for navigating to the next or previous display has changed to super shift arrows. You can now switch focus to another display using alt shift arrows and move a window to another display using shift alt super arrows. It got a little bit cumbersome there, but I understand what they're going for. Super plus and super minus can now be used to zoom in and out of the desktop. I thought that was the binding before. I know KDE uses that, so great, you've done that, but I thought that's what it already was. A seek ahead search option has been added to the file browser. Typing the first letter of a file or folder on the current page fills in the file path in the location bar and provides autocomplete options to speed up the process. To activate the settings, go in Cosmic Files, go to View, Settings. This is basically a choice of whether you want to search the current folder or start searching for a new folder. It's pretty much the easy way to put it. Sound balancing options. A left-right balance scale has been added to the sound settings to control the weight of sound in either ear. Usually, you're not going to need to touch this. This can be an accessibility thing for some people, or you could have broken headphones that you probably should replace. Either way, it is nice to have there. There's also some nice little performance things to highlight, like some general CPU optimization. When you resize a Cosmic application, like say, the settings window, it doesn't lock the CPU at 100%. The bar is in the wrong spot now. I don't even know how I did that. Okay, I'll try that afterwards. Whatever. If you don't have a Bluetooth device that is enabled, your CPU would also just lock at a really high amount. Besides video capture, as you've been able to tell the entire video, it feels all around smoother. We also have some some weird things like text overflow in the settings has now been addressed, which is great. It's not a big deal, right? Like, it doesn't really matter that much, but it's kind of annoying. Also, drop-downs appearing in the wrong location also generally being addressed. Scrolling now works in the workspace overview, so I can use my scroll wheel in here, which is nice to see. Zooming out. Here's a fun one. Here's a fun one. Zooming out at 100% zoom would actually zoom you in. Why? I don't know. This was not a very exciting release in terms of new features and new functionality, because we're trying to get to the point where beta is happening. Now, as you could tell from the video capture, there's still problems. It's still an alpha for a reason. But mostly now it's about dealing with performance issues, dealing with bugs, making sure everything's in place to be ready for a beta and then be ready for a full release where more people are going to try it, especially the beta. The beta, people are going to expect it to be quite a bit more stable, and then full release, you know, it better be pretty good by then. I really hope this video capture issue is dealt with by then. This is part of the reason I haven't streamed Cosmic. I might just stream Cosmic like this as a way to bully them into fixing the issue. Like, I'll just promote Cosmic in the worst possible way. Here you go. 500 people watching live just how buggy the portal is, so somebody looks at the issue. So as the biggest Cosmic bug tester, I will be here. I will be testing stuff. And there will probably be a stream. So check that out. I also need to do the 100k stream, but that's going to be done on KDE. Anyway, if you liked the video, go like the video. If you really liked the video and you want to become one of these amazing people over here, check out the Patreon, Scribes, LiberoPay linked in the description down below. I just noticed I didn't write anything for the whiteboard in this video. Huh. Anyway, these amazing people over here. Those things I already said. I ruined my outro. Yeah, I don't know how to go from here. Like this.